Hello everyone, in the last lecture, we already studied the xylem tissue, that is complex permanent tissue in xylem and the xylem elements. Now, let us see the another complex permanent tissue, that is phloem. Basically, the phloem is the complex permanent tissue. It is meant for the conduction of food. It is meant for the conduction of food, or it is the food conducting tissue. Now, the phloem is classified into four types, that is pseudotube, second companion cell, third phloem sclerenchyma, or phloem fibers, then fourth is phloem parenchyma. Let us see how the different types of the four elements of the phloem, they are arranged in a phloem tissue or arranged in a plant. Now, see the diagram here, see the figure. First, we see one by one, that is phloem elements. First is the pseudotube. Basically, this pseudotube is a tube-like structure. It is a cylindrical tube-like structure. This is a tube. This is another tube of pseudotube. This is a tube-like structure. This tube is having partitions, or having the end walls with the such a partitions, and that partition is called as sieve plate. That partition is called as sieve plate. That sieve plate, which is to be diagonally placed. Or it may be transversely placed. It may be placed diagonally, or it may be placed transversely. That sieve plate, which is to be accommodated or situated in a tube, hence that tube is called as sieve tube. No, the sieve plate, which is to be situated in a tube, that tube is called as a sieve tube. The sieve tube, having this plate, it may be diagonally or it may be transverse. That plate is, you see here this plate, having such a type of the pores. The pores are, or it is also called the perforations. This pores, which is to be having on the plate, that plate which is to be sometime diagonally or transversely placed here, through this pore the food material passes through one cell to other cell. It is going from one cell to other cell. It is translocated from one cell to other cell through this sieve tube or sieve plate, through the pores which is to be present on them. Sieve, in the sense in Marathi we say chadani. So like that, there is having a such type of the pore with on the plates, through which the food material passes from one cell to other cell. That is, so this one is sieve tube. It is accommodated or it is situated the sieve plates, and we say the sieve tube. First element is sieve tube or sieve tube element. It is also called a sieve tube element. Then the another constituent or another type of the phloem is the companion cell. Second is the companion cell. Basically, companion cell are those type of cell which is living one. It contains massive or dense or abundant cytoplasm, it is with nucleus, so that's why it is the living cell. This such type of the living cell, it is closely associated with the sieve tube. When the when particular type of the such a companion cells, they are always closely associated with the sieve tube, and that particular type of such a cells are called as companion cells. The cells is having abundant type of food material, abundant cytoplasm, not food material, abundant cytoplasm with nucleus, and such a massive and abundant cytoplasm which is to be having those cell which is to be closely associated with the sieve tube, and that is called as a companion cell. The most important thing about the companion cell, they are only present in the plants of angiosperm, in the group, in the plants or the group of angiospermic plants only. These companion cells are one of the important characteristic feature of the angiospermic plant. It is not present in other groups of plants like pteridophytes and gymnosperm. So this is to be the companion cells. This companion cell, it is having the nucleus, and this nucleus which is to be containing in the companion cell, it has control on the sieve tube. The nucleus which is to be in the companion cell controlling on the mechanism of sieve tube. Then we see that the another two types, that is the phloem sclerenchyma and phloem sclerenparenchyma. First we see the phloem sclerenchyma or phloem fibers. Basically sclerenchyma and the parenchyma both are the simple permanent tissue. These simple permanent tissue, when it is associated with the phloem elements, it is associated with the phloem element, that is we say the sieve tube and companion cell are the most main phloem elements. When first we see that is phloem sclerenchyma, the sclerenchymatous cells, they are associated, when they are associated with the sieve tube and companion cell, then it is said to be the phloem sclerenchyma or phloem fibers. Do you understand that the phloem sclerenchyma means the sclerenchymatous cells, they are associated with the phloem elements. The most of the phloem elements is sieve tube and companion cell is associated with the phloem element, then it is said to be the phloem sclerenchyma or phloem fibers. Similarly, the phloem parenchyma, when the parenchymatous cells, they are associated with the phloem elements, then it is said to be the phloem parenchyma. Then we say here, this one is the sclerenchymatous fibers here. So these are the sclerenchymatous fibers. These fibers are associated with the sieve tube. Then it is said to be the phloem sclerenchyma. Then this one is parenchymatous cells. These parenchymatous cells, they are associated with the sieve tube again. So this is called as phloem parenchyma. This one is phloem parenchyma. This one is phloem sclerenchyma. So that is the phloem. This one is the sieve tube, and it is there is having association with the sclerenchyma. So that's the phloem sclerenchyma. Then this one is the parenchyma, and this one is sieve tube. So the tube having the parenchymatous cells, so that is called as a phloem parenchyma. So we see that here the whole structure of the phloem tissue. So it is one of the water conducting tissue, sorry, food conducting tissue. It helps to conduct the food or to translocate the food from the manufacturing place to where there is required.